Welcome to the Ontraport Pages Grand Tour. In this video, I'm going to go over the page settings and block settings. You're going to learn how to create a page framework and edit the page and block settings so that your page turns out just how you want it. Let's jump in. Let's start at the very top bar. You'll see here that your page's name goes right at the top. Design is where you want to go to build your pages and access your element palette and pages canvas. Over here, Stats shows you your page's key performance indicators, like visits and conversions. If you've turned on split testing on your page, you can also check out the visits and conversions of every version of your page in one place. Cancel and save is where you can save your work without publishing your changes. You can continue to perfect your page until it's just right and save your work as you go. If you cancel, any changes made since the last save will be discarded. When you're ready to make your page go live, click Publish. You'll then choose the URL you want to publish your page to, and you can learn more about that in the video on publishing your pages. Every time you publish your page, your newest version will be added to your version history, and you can revert back to it at any time. Now let's take a look at the top toolbar. Here you can set font styles as you build, and you can tweak and change all the places where that style is being used with one simple move. So, it's a breeze to update if you change your mind down the road. Setting font styles is a good practice for keeping pages looking really clean. Too many fonts on a page can look messy, and we don't want you looking like an amateur. For example, let's say you have 5 field labels or subheadlines, and you decide you want to switch it up a little bit. Change the font, bold them up a little. You can do all that at once by changing the font style instead of editing each element individually. Colors work just like fonts. You can choose the 5 colors you want to use on your page and decide if you want to use them to color backgrounds or elements. When you change the color here, it will change all the places where that color is currently being used. So, imagine that you realize your brand's color is slightly off, but it's used all over the page. You can just swap out your color for the right hex code and have every element update automatically. Let's look at the page width next. Many people have giant screens, and letting your content spread across the whole screen can look really sloppy. In page width, you can add gutters to either side to keep your content neat, even on large screens. Here's Expedia.com as an example of a page that does this. This setting squeezes the blocks that live on a page. Because blocks sit on top of the page background is then exposed, which I'll show you in a minute. A full width page will never show any of the page's background because the blocks cover it edge to edge. We recommend that beginning designers select the large option, though it's really up to you. Whatever you choose, pick a size and use the same setting for all the pages on your site, because changing page width between pages is jarring and can make users feel a little nutty. You'll also want to check out the View Size tool to make sure your design is looking good on desktops and mobile devices. We're going to go into more detail on this in the video Designing for Mobile Screens. Now, let's look at version history. Marketers like to tinker with their pages over time to improve conversions. But sometimes your changes can have the opposite effect. With version history, you can revert your page back to your most recent version if that newest version isn't converting as well. If you love building pages in Ontraport, you might want to share them with other users. So here's where you can do that. You can share your pages in 2 different ways. First, you can share it with all users using the Ontraport Marketplace, or directly with individual users. You can choose to share that content for free, or you can even charge a fee for it. You can learn more about this process in our video on sharing pages. Split testing is a way of running an experiment to compare versions of a page to see which one performs better. When you turn on split testing on your pages and publish, Ontraport will automatically show different page visitors different versions of that page. And it'll evenly distribute the traffic among those different versions. We recommend that you change just one element of your page at a time, the headline, an image, the call to action button, etc. If you do this, it'll be easier to figure out why one page is winning over another. However, if you change too many variables at once, this won't be as clear. Note that a conversion here is counted when someone fills out a form. So, if your page doesn't have a form on it, this tool probably isn't the one that you should be using to optimize that page. If it does have a form, then give it a go. You'll see after a few days or weeks which page is performing better, and you can turn off the loser and try something else. In the Page Settings tab, you'll find a few more important settings. Here is where you can set your page's background to either a color, gradient, transparent, or add an image to your background to create the page design that you want. This is the background for the whole page, and what you put in the blocks on top of it will cover it. If your blocks have backgrounds and are full width, your page background will be completely covered and hidden. If your blocks aren't full width, however, you'll see the background on the sides of each block. In SEO and social settings, you can set important SEO tags, such as the title and meta description, directly in your page builder. Pick the image that you want to appear when you share links to your page on social media to make sure your posts look the way that you want as well. To keep your title tag from getting cut off, keep your title under 60 characters. Favicon allows you to add your branding to the tabs of your visitors' browsers. This is an easy way to make sure your pages are always identifiable and your branding is everywhere. Your favicon must be a 16 pixel by 16 pixel.ico file. And you can create a favicon using any of the free generators that you'll find by simply Googling favicon generator. With custom code, you can add custom code to your pages, and you can choose to add it to either your page's header, body, or footer. For example, you might want to add Google Analytics or Facebook tracking scripts to your Ontraport pages. Now, we recommend that you only add scripts that you really need to the page, because third-party pixels and scripts can really slow down the loading of a page, and nobody wants that. Using display settings, you can choose who can see your page. So, you can protect pages behind a login to make a membership site here, or create a page just for new visitors or contacts already existing in your database. Plus, you can choose where to send visitors to who don't meet your requirements. Display settings help you create a complete password-protected membership site, which we're going to dive into more in a separate series of videos. With Ontraform settings, you can create a pop-up that appears based on your visitors' actions, such as how long they spend on your page or how far they scroll. So, you can pop a lightbox with a special offer or opt-in form when your visitor has scrolled down a certain percentage of your page. That way, you can still grab attention, but not annoy your visitors with pop-ups as soon as they land on your site. Another great way to use pop-ups is to only show your lightbox after your visitors have been on your page for a certain amount of time. Exit intent pop-ups are a great way to make a final effort to collect your visitors' data by popping a form when they're about to leave. This works best if you have a good incentive for visitors to sign up. You can learn more about these settings in the video on Ontraforms. In block layout mode, you can make adjustments to a number of block settings. As you learned in an earlier video, a page is composed of individual blocks, and each block has its own layout and settings. Let's dive into a single block by clicking this gear icon on the right. This shows you all sorts of additional settings and features. In block settings, you can add a block name. Name your block so that you can easily find and distinguish between them if you ever want to use them again on another page or reference it in a link, for example. You can create more advanced designs when you set backgrounds for specific blocks. You can choose from transparent, colors, image, and video. And if you select colors, you can even create a gradient. So, if your page has an image as its background, you can set your block's background to transparent so that you can see that page background. Or, if you want your block to stand out, you can add a color background to it. Fine-tune your block's layout using your spacing settings, which are margins and padding. Margins are the space around an element. They're on the outside of your rows, columns, blocks, and elements. Since your blocks are stacked on top of each other, you can add margins to the top and bottom to push other blocks away. Padding is the space between the container and the contents inside of it. Padding adds space inside of your blocks. You can add padding to the top, bottom, left, and right to shift where your content sits inside of your block. Here's where this may come in handy. Let's say you've created the perfect layout on your page using columns and rows to put your elements exactly where you want them. But let's say you just want a little bit more space between your blocks and the next block on the page. Push your margin slider until you have enough space, like this. It's a good idea not to add huge margins or padding to make your blocks look the way that you want. If you need to add big chunks of space, add additional columns or rows. This will make your page far more responsive to multiple screen sizes, and you're going to spend less time formatting your pages to make them look the way you want. Your block size setting allows you to choose how tall or wide you want your block to be. This is how to choose your block content's maximum width. Choose default if you want there to be margins on the sides of your block. Choose full if you want your block to extend to the sides of the screen. To adjust your block's height, you can choose default if you want your block's height to match the size of the elements that you put inside, or you can choose match viewport to make your block as tall as the screen it's being viewed on. This is kind of a cool effect and worth trying out to see how you like it. You can also stylize your block using border, arrow, and shadow. Adding a border or shadow to it can make your block stand out. You've also got settings that control exactly how your border or shadow will appear. Here's an example of when you might use these settings. Let's say you want to highlight your product benefits section of your page and make sure that it sticks out. You can add a drop shadow so that the most important information on your page really grabs people's attention. Now let's look at the sticky block settings. If you have a really important block on your page, you can make sure that your visitors always see it by sticking it to the top of the page. For example, you can make the opt-in form on your pages sticky so anytime your visitors are on your page, it's easy for them to opt in. Your display settings are a way to customize who can see this particular block and when. There are three settings to choose from, and you can use them in combination with each other. In device display, you can choose which devices your block should be visible on. Now, if you find that one of your blocks looks great on desktop, but it looks a little weird and complicated on mobile, no problem. You can create a desktop-only version and a mobile-only version of the same block so that it'll look great on either device. Delayed display allows you to choose when you want your block to appear on your page. Show your block immediately or have your block magically appear after a set amount of time. This is a great way to include offers on your page without overwhelming your visitors. Instead of showing your opt-in offer the second your visitor lands, you can wait a few seconds. Then show your offer to someone you think isn't going to immediately bounce off the page. Using conditional display, you can choose exactly who you want your block to be visible to based on what you know about them or what they've done in the past. This is an awesome way to create special offers. You could create offers for brand new leads, to people who have already opted in, or to people who have purchased from you before. So you might use it to, say, create a new sign-up offer just for new leads. You would set your block's display settings to anonymous visitors only. That way, you can add a lead capture form to your page and only show it to people who haven't already opted in. Or you can show an upsell offer to visitors who purchased a specific product. For example, let's say you sold an expensive pair of leather shoes to a customer. You can then show them your shoe shine kit to maintain their shoes. We're going to go into a deep dive into conditional block settings in our video on personalizing with conditional display blocks. We've covered pages and we've covered page settings. And then we drilled in to look at a single block and settings for that block. Now we're going to drill in one level deeper to a single column within a single block. We can get even more specific with our settings and create some really cool designs. When you hover over a column when you're editing a block, you can click the settings icon to see the settings for a specific column. You have three settings that are available for blocks: background, spacing, and border, arrow, and shadow. And your settings work in exactly the same way as they do for blocks. You can set your column's background to a specific color or image, or make it transparent so that you can totally control your page's design. Use the spacing to add padding and margins and set the alignment of the content in the specific column that you're editing. Border, arrow, and shadow settings help you make specific columns stand out from the rest of your blocks. With these settings, you can make things look like individual cards, for example, or any other number of cool designs. Pretty rad. Okay, wow, we've covered a lot in this Ontraport Pages Grand Tour, but now you know about the page level and the block settings. Congratulations. In future videos, we're going to talk about all the elements that you can start to add to your pages.